The tight-knit, secretive community of Gloriavale has for decades fascinated and disturbed. Allegations of serious misconduct, horrific stories from those who've left, whistleblowers left shunned and broken. Just how ingrained was the culture of abuse? Well, tonight we confront its leaders, but first, John Campbell meets the survivors and outlines the extraordinary rules governing Gloriavale.
Almost every story about Gloriavale features a shot like this, of the empty road in. But the bigger journey by far is getting out. Leaving Gloriavale means leaving your home, your family, everything. It can also mean taking on the leaders, and if you ask people the cost of that...
it costs you everything.
We've tried ever since, well, before we left and ever since after, to talk to them, to try and help them see things that we had come to and seen, and we've just had resistance the whole way. And it's been really hurtful that they don't want to know.
And why is it hurtful?
Because I know people are still getting hurt.
To escape the hurt, you leave Gloriavale for somewhere almost as remote, beginning a new life, maybe here, in the jagged emptiness of inland North Canterbury. Down there, the disciple family, who left late last year, are starting to heal. Hopeful and Victory Disciple have seven children, loved to the sky and back. They fled Gloriavale to keep them safe, to give them a childhood, to free them from the weight of that place.
I think every parent in Gloriavale needs to seriously consider, what are they allowing to happen to their children?
Is this a safe place for children?
No. I mean, to me, we all have children in there, and we had our children there because we believed it was the best place for them. And then when we saw it damaging our children the same way we were damaged, it just really...
The hurt began with this man, Neville Cooper, Gloriavale's leader for nearly 50 years, who in the mid-90s was jailed for sexual offending. At about the same time, Gloriavale moved here, 60k inland from Greymouth, out of sight of the world, where it was governed with an all-controlling manifesto called What We Believe. What We Believe tells the people of Gloriavale they must obey the leaders and submit themselves willingly to them as unto the Lord. So, Gloriavale's leaders are equal to God, and so too are husbands, to whom wives must submit themselves as unto the Lord and obey them in all things. Which leads us to an extraordinary command, and this is verbatim. Husbands and wives do not have the right to withhold themselves sexually from one another. Did you understand you could say no?
No, we were taught we could never say no.
And it actually goes further than that. I know it does mention husband and wife, but most of the teaching and most of the whole vibe we got from Hopeful was that the wife is not allowed to say no to the husband.
Mm-hmm. You know, your job as a wife is to make sure your husband's never going to have an excuse to be unfaithful. And so you have to give them everything, anywhere, anytime. That's it.
And yeah. Did you believe, Victory, that that was how life was?
Yeah.
That was publicly taught. no one sort of knew or understood the way a healthy relationship should be. And yeah, we really only started understanding it after coming out.
Oh, that's nice.
Faithful, his wife and their 8 children have been out for just over a year. Gloriavale was breaking him.
I know that people in there will disagree with me, but there are so many abusive marriages. And we don't even know that they're abusive.
I really cared for her. And yet, the mindset that I'd grown up with meant for the first 8 years of our marriage, I hurt her more than anyone else. And that's what I want to get across to the people in Gloriavale, the husbands in Gloriavale. They can be hurting their wives without even realising it because of that culture we've grown up with, that unhealthy sexual culture.
So where does this leave women in Gloriavale in terms of their ability to consent or not?
Doesn't exist. It's not a word that exists in Gloriavale. Not a concept. You have no right.
You have no right to say no?
No. Not to your husband. No.
So how common is rape in marriage in Gloriavale?
I won't comment on it. But you're reading their own document and you're understanding correctly.
We have come to Timaru, bustling on a blue, blue early winter morning. There in the background are the Alps, and when people cross them from Gloriavale, escaping, this South Canterbury city is often their first stop. Below us, Liz Gregory and the Gloriavale Leavers Support Trust are waiting to begin the unbreaking.
It's an extremely unhealthy culture. And there are broken people.
Inside her shipping container office, Gloriavale's leaders and trustees watch down from the walls. This is the past Liz Gregory's team helps you leave. Outside, the future, things for their new lives, much of it donated, and bikes, so many bikes for the children, many of whom have never known the outside world.
We're just part of a big team of people who care.
You care so much, don't you?
Yeah, we do. We do. They're precious people. They're people who've had a bad deal. They've been duped, they've been lied to, they've been abused. And then they come out here and have to face the judgment and criticism from their family back in there, who just wants to pass it off. You're just bitter. You just won't forgive.
Radio, come on. Come down to school.
Maybe we should sit at the table.
Let's go.
And,
let's go.
It was the abuse they fled, hopeful, Victory, and their children, who are now homeschooled in the old farmhouse they're living in.
So what are you going to do for art?
We spent a day with them, and you can see how everyone is blooming in this safety and this love. Hopeful and Victory left Gloriavale so their children would never go through what they went through. The injury of abuse, the insult of somehow blaming yourself.
There must be something wrong with me.
Yeah.
And that's what I believed my whole life.
You don't have to answer this question, but were you sexually abused?
Yeah.
And there's no way out for you, is there?
No. do you not, I mean, do you actually learn not to say anything, not to tell anyone, because then you become ostracised?
Mm.
I mean, I know I've got some dear friends that were never allowed to get married because what happened to them got public and they were ostracised for it. And
the victims, just, victims were blamed.
It damaged them for the rest of their life.
Yeah.
How common is it, do you think, Victory?
Very. And I know above me and below me, dozens and dozens of women who were sexually abused as girls and teenagers.
You're here on my invitation. This is the reality of my life, the reality of what's been happening to me and my wife over the last 18 months.
I would liken it to torture.
On a morning when the mist and cloud hover, thicken, then turn to rain, we meet Clem Reddy. We're across the lake from Gloriavale itself, Clem's terrible home.
The hatred that the leaders say they don't have for my wife and I, the people don't hide it.
Hatred?
Hatred, mate.
Clem has invited us in.
Right, we've just hit Gloriavale.
Once, those were the days he helped tame this heavy land.
And all these paddocks around us here when we first came here back in the late 90s, it was all just rushes and swamp.
And now Clem lives here with his wife, Sharon, if you can call it living.
A little life that we've managed to eke out for ourselves in kind of pathetic circumstances, in a sense.
You don't realise how pathetic until we arrive. Gloriavale's residents live in the big white buildings ahead.
These are the accommodation hostels, 1, 2, 3, 4, and the central one is the dining room.
But Clem and Sharon are banned from all of them. This is where they're fighting to stay.
So this is our little room. Coming in here.
The noise of the workshop.
Well, yeah, compressor starting up. Through here. Welcome to our home.
This is it.
This is it. This is it.
The room contains much of what they own, small mementos of this strange life. This is what their room opens out to. It's freezing cold. And outside, in that cold, somewhere up beneath the cloud, they have children living.
So, Clem, your children and grandchildren are roughly 250 metres over there.
Yep.
Roughly. And you're telling me that you're not allowed to go and visit them?
No.
Are they allowed to come down here and talk to you?
No.
Clem's life here has its own demons. He disciplines some of his own children so severely, beating them with his hands, a shoe, a belt, that he received 12 months supervision. But he pleaded guilty and went to Gloriavale's leaders to demand a sexual abuser do the same thing.
They wouldn't leave the single girls alone. It was just disgusting. So, oddly enough...
Clem, single girls, how old are we talking here?
Well, we're talking about girls from about the age of 13, 14, through, well, right into their early 20s.
Is Gloriavale a safe place for girls 13 and 14 up?
Well, it might be a little safer now, a little, but for years it just definitely wasn't, and this went on for years.
So you raised this with the leadership?
Yes.
And the leadership's response was not to investigate or discourage or intervene with him.
No.
It was to clamp down on you.
Yes, exactly.
Clem and Sharon would leave, but they can't. They have little money. And they have children here, and grandchildren, and another connection to this place. Their daughter, Priya, is buried in Gloriavale's graveyard. Priya was 14 when she died, in heartbreaking circumstances. She choked to death on food in a Gloriavale sickness isolation room, which had its door handles removed to keep the sick inside. As she choked, people couldn't get in except through a window.
And they have worked incredibly hard, but they have no money, no nest egg, and nowhere to go. So you know where they go? In there, into a hangar, where there is a freezing, tiny, makeshift bedroom awaiting them. And that is their life in Gloriavale now. That is it.
So you're just looking at a society that has run on manipulation, bullying, intimidation, lies. So you're talking about a cover-ups, not acknowledging people's pain and suffering, lack of care and empathy.
Hopeful Christian bullied everyone. Everyone that even knew Hopeful got bullied by Hopeful. And the ones that stayed in the community became bullies themselves. And they bully the ones under them, and they bully the ones under them, and it filters down to the children.
Which is why they leave, to stop themselves passing the bullying on. This beautiful location, with its ugly secrets. Packing their few possessions and their kids and driving out, turning east and crossing the Alps to new lives. Roughly 220 leavers have made that trip in the last 9 years.
I think it was back in 2010 I started a journey that would bring me here.
Faithful's journey, as he calls it, began with him questioning whether the leaders were living the Christian scriptures they taught.
That was going to put me on a collision course with them.
Are you able, Faithful, to tell us what you went through, or is that just not somewhere you can go?
I would liken it to torture. Essentially, that's what it was. It is just overwhelmingly terrible.
And it's about humiliation?
Yeah.
Breaking every ounce of your spirit?
That's right.
And reducing you to nothing but a cowed and subservient and beaten and broken man. Am I overstating it here?
Not at all. I was going to use some of those same words, but I just couldn't quite speak. It was...
Hello, John Campbell from TVNZ.
You're trespassing here.
What's that?
You're trespassing. You don't have permission to be here.
We've heard from former Gloriavale members who allege widespread and institutionalised abuse inside the community. So, what do those in charge have to say? John Campbell heads inside Gloriavale.
Salem, John Campbell from TVNZ, do you want to have a chat to us?
Oh, no, thanks.
You sure? There's a lot to discuss. We called, we emailed, we visited. No, no, no. Hello, John Campbell from TVNZ.
You're trespassing here.
What's that?
You're trespassing. You don't have permission to be here.
Well, we've arrived seeking permission.
Well, we're not giving you permission. We'd like you to leave now.
OK, what's your name?
If you're a great journalist, you'll find that out.
Good morning, Mr. Righteous.
Good morning, Your Honour. Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
This footage is from the employment court earlier this year. Peter Righteous for Gloriavale, able to answer questions then, including about accusations of sexual abuse made against another Gloriavale man.
So it's a complaint against an older male by a young girl?
Yes, correct, yes.
I just want to know from you, why didn't you call the police?
At that stage, as I said, we were not under our current... child protection policy. We've had long-standing issues of reporting crime to the police. We felt that it was better to handle it within ourselves.
Are you satisfied that this is a safe place for children?
Yes, I am. And I'm telling you again, you're trespassing and I'm asking you to leave.
Your point of view will be expressed if you give it. In its absence, all we have from Gloriavale is silence.
That's exactly right. But we don't trust you.
And so...
Thank you. Can you call the police, please?
The same police they didn't call when a girl there told them she'd been sexually abused.
The truth is that it's not a safe place mentally, physically, emotionally for people to live in.
Which is why Hopeful and Victory got their beloved children and left to protect them from the abuse. the lies, the silence, and also the way things just happen when they shouldn't, like how Hopeful, their dad, became a teacher.
9 o'clock at night, on a Sunday evening, the principal knocks on her door, comes in, right, so you're going to be teaching school tomorrow.
Sorry to interrupt, but any qualifications?
None. Any
training?
No. So I got away with horrific abuse in the classroom because I had no training. I just, when a frustrating situation came up, and with 20-odd kids, that's quite regularly that you get to the end of your rope, and I just used all the bullying tactics that I had seen throughout my life on these kids.
We drove past the school on the way in, that building on the left, and it's aero-checked, but everyone we've spoken to told us the visiting agencies get a manufactured version of reality, not the full truth. Even so, aero did have some concerns about safety provisions.
Us younger teachers, we said, you're right on the button. It is not a safe place for very different reasons to what aero saw. And so the leadership, of course, you know, scrambled and got the policies in place. And so aero did say at the end of their report, yes, they've now done what's necessary to become a safe place.
Have they?
No, they haven't.
And so the question is, and lest we forget, the mean age of community members is 12 years old. Who is keeping an eye on them? Who is asking questions on their behalf? And who is getting the answers that can make us all believe that those children really are safe? Back in Timaru, in her container office, Liz Gregory, herself a Christian, says no one is.
This box here is all the government correspondence, charity services.
So hold on a sec. These are emails you have sent to government agencies.
This is 2.5 years worth of information sent to charities, just highlighting the difficulties within Gloriavale. We've got police, Ministry of Education, Oranga Tamariki, Ministry of Health and doctors. And then we have been liaising with the Royal Commission. So there has to be some recognition somewhere along the way that actually people did know. And somewhere along the way, no one felt like they had the ability or the power or the right to act. It's been upsetting and frustrating.
I think these agencies were extremely naive. They do not understand how cults work.
Faithful has a job now. He loves it. And it's made him understand how unlike a normal workplace Gloriavale is. Visiting Gloriavale is to see what they show you. Like driving backwards, some of the view just disappears.
When an agency's arriving, is there an attempt made to tell you what you can say to control the narrative, to make sure the message is what the leaders want it to be?
Always, always has been.
Dear Father, we thank you for this food.
Lunchtime. They're getting there, the disciple family. The kids are learning to trust the world and to feel safe in it. But there's a way to go when you suddenly feel a community you'd spent your life in was built on lies.
It's probably more than just that we've been lied to. We've actually lived the lie ourselves. Because all the lies that I got told, I passed on to my children. We're all in the wheel of being the liar. And I guess that's the liberating thing for me, is that I don't have to lie anymore.
When you see wrong being done, every person on this planet has the duty to stand up and say, this is wrong, and call it out.
Is that what you're doing?
That's what I'm doing. That's why I'm here today.
Faithful started the calling out years ago inside Gloriavale. His was a lonely bravery against great odds. He's broken still, but less so. And he sees light out here, and a future the rest of us might regard as ordinary, but which feels almost miraculous to him.
It's been a roller coaster, as they say. it definitely has its ups and downs, but it's worth it. It's worth it to see my children safe and happy and living with dignity, having a childhood. It's worth it to see my wife blooming as a woman in her own right now. And it's worth it for me to be treated with respect and to be a father, to be a husband, to be a provider for my family. It's definitely worth it.
Well, those we spoke to say there are still good people inside Gloriavale and ask that the public show them tolerance. Now, 4 days after we visited Gloriavale, its leaders released a statement denouncing all offending and apologising for failing to protect victims. They point to new child safety measures, including a special team overseen by Oranga Tamariki and weekly visits from an independent social worker. They also say members are fully supported, including financially, if they choose to leave. Well, for more on the story, do go to our One News website. E haere ake nei, we're celebrating Matariki, but what does that actually mean?
Mena ka tū honohono anō tātou ki ēnei mōmō kōrero, ki tēnei mahi te tātai aroraki, ka ora tātou.